All right, now me and Arthur still talking about how Twitter and getting followers is one of those important things in a market where influencers make a lot of sense in pushing products and influencing people like you to attend events like the Navana Fest. But for now, let's talk about the 16 days of activism. It's a hashtag that was on Twitter, and I picked it up, I think, from Kaka. She was talking about it, and there's a tweet shot somewhere, and I picked up on it. Now, on the show, I am pleased to also have Josh, who was a part of it. And before we get into the boat cruise incident, let's first talk about the 16 days of activism.
16 days, initially brought about by the UN under the Department of UN Women in 1991. So they put aside 16 days to enlighten the people about the dangers of violence against women and girls, because, you know, in our communities, these people are really marginalized. Like, if you go to the villages, in those local council meetings and all that, when a woman puts up a hand amidst men, they cannot give her time to speak whatever she wants. So they start from 25th November to 10th December, which is the Human Rights Day. Yes, so they use an orange color. If you've been following that hashtag, some people are using orange the world. So they use the orange color to provide awareness. So what they do is, if any organization or anyone, they can paint anywhere orange or put on orange t-shirts or clothes, just to create awareness about ending violence against girls and women, because it happens everywhere. It has no boundaries. Violence against women doesn't know whether someone went to school or not. I think you've seen there's an ambassador who was in the US who beat his wife and he was deported. And again, if you go to the villages, same stuff is happening. So people need to know about the dangers.
What's your take on speaking out in regards to gender-based violence?
Yes, it's I've had luckily, I thank God, I've had experience abroad. I went to school in the US, I traveled around, so I am confident to stand up and talk in the midst of people, not just men, you know. But some people don't have that, because you're trained from as a girl to just, you know, stay together, be respect yourself, but don't. Now with that kind of put yourself together on your own, it doesn't give you that stand to get up and, you know, someone beat me yesterday, you know. It's one of those, you know what, I'll get over it, I'm a woman, you know, that's it. But then people forget that you have the ability to stand up and be like, I was hurt.
I'm having your lawyer. How are we doing in the legal world? Do you think that GBV is being taken seriously with the laws that we have in Uganda, or do you think that maybe we need to sit in parliament and re-sketch some of these things?
The narrative, unfortunately, the narrative about changing laws or amending them and blah 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 has been around for some time, but I guess it comes from lazy minds. No offense. The laws we have are sufficient to address these issues. It's just the enforcement. And it's just the enforcement of these laws that is lacking. The lack of awareness of the laws among the people, and the culture stereotypes we have in Uganda. You asked Mariam here about what her take is on speaking out. You will find that while it's quite easy for the woman to speak out and say, hey, this happened, for the man it's a different thing altogether, because in culture the man is supposed to be a macho.
Let me just ask each one of you to just give their two cents about, you know, the capsized boat. Just your two final words about the whole thing.
I think mine will be like something nice about Brian White. Previously, these guys were thinking this guy just throws money around for stupid causes. But for the first time, I'm seeing something that is more of CSR. Like, people have been seeing him just showing off his money and
why
stuff.
Is this guy?
But finally...
Why are you laughing?
Finally, the money is being... used very well, because the locals, I watched some news and they were getting 100,000 per corpse that they bring, and much as the people are dead, but people really want to go and bury their people and then follow up with the bank things and stuff like that.
I don't want to ask you about Brian White. The thing is, let's just give our two cents about the capsized boat. Ernest Brian White is the most important.
There's nothing to talk about Brian White. There are too many question marks around him. I don't want to honor him with my time. But I want to talk about two things in relation to the boat capsizing. I want to talk about social justice, and I want to talk about our education system. What exactly about social justice? I have on numerous occasions on my social media talked about the importance of everyone in society, people around you, being well off. You get. Now, when you bring it in the context of the capsized boat, the narrations we've been hearing from the survivors are that many people actually drowned, not because they couldn't swim, but because while they were trying to swim, those who could not swim were holding onto them and holding them back. You get. So that is what happens with our society. If you're the only person fool to think that, since I'm well off, it's all good. It takes just a moment before you lose it all because of these people are not doing well. I mean, if they have to kill you to survive, they will do that. Education system. Irene Namubiru made a post and said, among other things, that the only reason why she survived is because she learned how to swim in Namasagari College. Then let me tell you something brief about that school. At the time Irene was studying from there, they were studying from morning up to 1 p.m. And then after 1 p.m., kids would go for extracurricular activities, which included swimming, farming, blah, 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 and all sorts of things. Clearly, that's a school which did not put a premium on just academics alone. It put a premium on other things alone. Now, in so doing, it inadvertently saved Irene's life. Ultimately, what saved her were not her grades. It was that extra thing she got involved in outside school. So if our education system could be steeped to reflect the idea that Namasagari represented at the time Irene Namubiru was in school, that would be a good thing. Yeah. Brian White is a non-entity.
Let me come to your two cents about the whole capsized boat thing. What do you think about that, and how should we move on from this?
Well, I first of all would like to appreciate social media. I didn't know that. I didn't see the importance of social media till this weekend. Something like that happened, but everyone I know knew about it. Like everyone was aware of something is happening. Before, it used to take you a while to know something happened in Lake Victoria, but now everyone knows. Now, not knowing it alone, but also now people are taking more precautions. Like, don't just get in a boat. You know, okay, we are excited, it's December, so we're gonna do the most. No, you have to be careful, you know. Life jackets are there. If they're not there, wait for the next cruise. Like, it's just chill. You're gonna get on the boat. Like, we should take more precautions and also take care of yourself. Like, just because he's gonna go on a boat, I can't swim. But because he can swim, I was like, you know what, he can swim, I'm okay. No. Take responsibility of yourself, and also be sure, like, where you're going, it's safe. And once you know there's something off, please alert someone, because there are people in the boat that knew something was wrong, but they couldn't speak up.
Some of them were told, because
they're high. There we go. Something was off. People just keep quiet. Speak up. If something is wrong, I will say it. Even if I'm freaking out of nowhere, I'll say it, because you're gonna end up saving so many lives than keep quiet. You know.
Wow. Hashtag speak out. What are your two cents, on the capsized boat?
First of all, I want to send my condolences to the families who lost family members and friends. But then, secondly, I was angry at Ugandans who wanted to use the Paul died as a way of making comedy and jokes. Because if you check on several social media platforms, people are coming out to make fun of the capsized boat. Now, for example, one of the girls on Twitter tweeted that what if the boat was doing the other challenge? What is it called?
Malwede.
Yeah, that challenge.
People unfollowed that chick.
Seriously, it was really blocked. Sad. Then also something else that happened. Now everyone started coming out as if they are related to someone who died when they were not. Like. Like RIP friend, blah, 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 when they didn't have any attachment. But because they know about some people who had the money, so they want to be attached to such people. So everyone started putting, okay, it's okay to mourn, but you can mourn without trying to relate with someone who
died.
Like,
you have to mourn with respect.
Mourn with respect. Yeah, it was really sad.
In most cases, sometimes when a person or like a country loses, the emotions go beyond the fact that you know someone. You get personally. There's one of the guys who survived who I watched with the match. Just one day, like in my whole life, and the guy was almost dying. But man, at that moment, it was as if we were family, you get?
But there's people that really pretend. I think I get his point.
Pretenders. No,
they're pretenders. There are people who...
First wait. And then there's this thing where I read on someone's Snapchat. People are sharing their Snapchat stories. And they were like, far from the person, they would know that this is the guy. Maybe this is really what they've never talked about anything. And they've never told them about their lifestyle, how it could put them in danger, stuff like that. And they just leave them. And the person is finally going to die, you get? Yeah. So they were feeling that grief of not talking to this person.
All right, we've come to the end of the show. Follow at 16, hashtag 16 days of activism. Follow Nirvana Fest, follow Willis Daily, follow Sassy Marvin, follow Digital Didan, and follow at Monk E. See you guys next week on Saturday. And remember, I'm Monday to Friday. I'm on Urban Today and still giving you what's trending on the timeline. Bye, and have yourselves a wonderful week.